Welcome to Catherine's tutorial. In this video, we'll learn about Lac Opéron concept. Lac Opéron is also known as lactose Opéron. Opéron is nothing but cluster of genes in DNA, which will be under the control of one gene. So cluster of genes will be under the control of one gene. Okay, so in other words, we can able to say a group of genes with related functions together, they are known as Opéron. So what is this lactose Opéron is about? It is about the gene expression. Okay, what is gene expression? We all know DNA is a genetic material. It stores genetic information. It also takes care of the process of protein synthesis. DNA cannot able to come out of the nucleus, so it transcribes a message into mRNA. So by a process known as transcription, when there is a need of protein synthesis. So DNA transcribes a message into mRNA, and after this process, after transcription, the mRNA will move to cytoplasm with the help of other cytoplasmic organelles like ribosomes and tRNA, rRNA. The amount of proteins are synthesized. There are amino acid or polypeptide chains are synthesized. So this is known as gene expression. For example, the first example will go with antibodies. What are antibodies? They are nothing but WBC. The amount of antibodies will be normal when there is no pathogen. The amount of antibodies will increase when there is pathogen. So when there is a need, the amount of or the number of antibodies will increase in our blood plasma, and they can able to neutralize this pathogen. Antibodies are not always produced in an increased rate. When there is a need, our body synthesizes WBC to fight against infection. One more example we can go with, that is nothing but insulin. We all know insulin controls the blood glucose level. When there is increased blood glucose level in our bloodstream, the hormone insulin converts the excess glucose into glycogen. It stores them in liver and muscles. When there is a need, when there is excess blood glucose level, this insulin is produced. Okay, when there is a need, these hormones are produced. When there is a need, these antibodies are produced. So it is not all the cells or all the hormones or proteins in our body are synthesized all through the day. When there is a need, these substances are produced. So that is known as gene expression. Some type of genes will always produce substances or enzymes or proteins or whatsoever. Those types of genes are known as constitutive genes. So here we are going to learn about the gene expression. Gene expression in E. coli. That is what we are going to learn under Lac Opéron concept. So now we will learn about Lac Opéron concept. But before getting into Lac Opéron concept, we should know some basics about this Lac Opéron concept that will be very helpful to learn the Lac Opéron concept clearly. So this Lac Opéron concept, as I have told you already, it is explaining the gene expression in E. coli. This was explained by Jacob and Monod. They are 1965, they were given with Nobel Prize for their discovery of gene expression in E. coli. We'll draw the Lac Opéron concept model. So here we have a promoter gene. And we have Lac I gene. Here we have one more promoter. And here we have an operator gene. And here we have the structural genes. So these three are known as structural genes. So here we have the termination codon. So now we'll learn one by one, then we'll just mark the parts. This region is known as promoter region. So we always know the promoter region will help the further process of transcription or translation. So this is a promoter region, and this region is known as LacI gene. Okay, so this is LacI gene followed by promoter gene. This is operator gene. This is LacZ, LacY, LacA, and this is the termination codon. So this is the structure of Jacob and Monod model of lacopyrin concept. So we'll just learn one by one what are these lacs of genes and what are these promoters and what is their function. Go with LacI gene. So I represents inducer. Sometime it will be written as R, that represents repressor. So LacR or I gene, I represents inducer or R represents repressor. So this LacI gene will produce a lac mRNA. This lac mRNA produces a protein known as repressor protein. So what is the function of this repressor protein? This repressor protein will go and bind with operator gene. Operator gene. If it goes and binds with operator gene, the process of lactose metabolism will not occur. Suppose in case this repressor protein doesn't bind with the operator gene. So it doesn't bind with the operator gene. Now the lactose metabolism producing or lactose metabolism will go on. So this repressor protein will initiate whether the lactose metabolism should occur or not according to the food that is present in the surrounding medium for this E. coli organism. Now we'll move on to the next one, that is a promoter region. And one more important thing, towards the promoter region you can able to find one more site, that is known as cap. Cap region, it is catabolite activator protein. So this is present before the promoter region. Okay, so now this promoter region, next region we are going to learn is about the promoter. This promoter region has a sequence to initiate the process of lactose metabolism. So we need one more enzyme also here, that is nothing but RNA polymerase enzyme. Imagine if this RNA polymerase enzyme comes and binds with the promoter region. Okay, so I'll write here, if RNA polymerase enzyme binds with promoter region, the process of transcription will start for lactose metabolism. And if RNA polymerase doesn't combine here, the process of transcription will not start actually. Okay, so this RNA polymerase involves in the process of transcription if there is a need of lactose metabolism. So they come and attach to the promoter region to go with the process of further transcription. The next region what you're going to learn is about the operator gene. Operator gene. So what is the function of operator gene? This operator gene has two mechanism, switch on mechanism and switch off mechanism. What is this on and off mechanism? The complete concept, the whole concept of lacopyrin is based on lactose metabolism done by the E. coli. If E. coli is present in our intestine, they absorb the digested food from the human intestine, that is nothing but glucose. Glucose is easily available for these group of organism, and conversion of glucose into their carbon source doesn't require much energy. So they always prefer to take glucose as their energy source. Suppose if there is no glucose in the surrounding medium, the E. coli has to go on with the metabolism of lactose to produce energy. So that is known as lac-opiron concept or lactose-opiron concept. So the concept is completely based on lactose metabolism. When there is a need, the mechanism or the metabolism of lactose will start. When there is no need of lactose metabolism, the organism will take up glucose as their energy product. So here the operator gene involves in switching off or switching on the mechanism of lactose metabolism. Now we'll just see what happens here. When the repressor protein, okay, I'll just write it in a short form. When the repressor protein binds with the operator region, the condition will become off. It will not, repressor protein will bind with the operator region. Complex will not allow the RNA polymerase to come and bind with the promoter sequences. So there will be no transcription. Because why there is no transcription? Because the organism has glucose in the environment. They doesn't need to depend upon this lactose metabolism. There is no need of producing enzyme that is essential for lactose metabolism. So, when the repressor protein binds with the operator region, the lactose metabolism will not occur. That is nothing but the RNA polymerase is not going to attach with the promoter region. So, transcription process will not occur. When transcription occurs, translation will also occur, producing the enzyme necessary for the lactose metabolism. So, there is no need. So, that is why the complex will not allow the RNA polymerase to bind with the promoter region. Suppose if the repressor protein doesn't bind with the operator region, the mechanism will become on. So why, when this will happen? When there is no glucose in the surrounding medium, the organism has to go for lactose metabolism. For lactose metabolism, they have to synthesize the proteins, that is nothing but enzymes. So for that, they have to go for a process of transcription. When there is no binding of repressor protein with the operator region, the RNA polymerase binds with the promoter site and the transcription process will occur. So they will produce the lac mRNA. This lac mRNA will undergo translation to produce protein. So this is what will happen when repressor protein doesn't bind with the operator gene. That is why the operator gene has switched off and on mechanism. So if repressor protein binds with operator, there will be no lactose metabolism. If repressor protein doesn't bind with the operator, lactose metabolism will go on. So this is known as switch off and on mechanism. So that is a function of operator gene. Next thing what you are going to learn is about these three genes. These three genes are known as structural genes. This system is known as polycistronic or polycistron. Why it is known as polycistron? One single promoter gene controls the expression of these three structural genes. So this is known as polycistronic mechanism, or they are known as polycistronic genes, because all these three genes are under the control of this one promoter gene. That is why it is known as polycistron. Now we'll go on with the structural genes and what is their function. The first structural gene is nothing but lac-EZ. This lac-EZ produces beta-galactosidase enzyme. So this beta-galactosidase enzyme will break the lactose into glucose and galactose. It will break the lactose into glucose and galactose. That is a function of beta-galactosidase enzyme. The next gene we have is lac-Y gene that produces beta-galactosidase permease. We can able to understand the meaning of the term permease, permeable. Okay, so what happens here? When the lactose metabolism has to go on, it has to enter inside the E. coli organism. Imagine it is an E. coli. It has to enter inside the E. coli. So what happens here? It makes the channels on the cytoplasm of this organism. It binds with the cytoplasm of the organism and it allows the entry of lactose inside the cell. So it allows the entry of lactose inside the cell by attaching with the cytoplasmic membrane of this E. coli. So that is a function of galactosidase permease enzyme. And the lac-A, it is known as beta-galactosidase transacetylase. It helps in transferring the acetyl group acetyl CoA.
Helps in transferring the acetyl group. There is a function of beta galactosidase transacetylase. So these are the basics you have to learn when you start to learn the concept of lacopyran. I'm repeating again. The E. coli absorbs glucose from the human intestine as a carbon source. And eventually what happens here, when there is no glucose, the organism has to go for lactose metabolism. If both the glucose and lactose present in the environment, that is the surrounding environment, the E. coli will prefer only to take up glucose, because lactose metabolism requires much energy and it is a time consuming process and energy consuming process. So they always prefer to take up glucose as their food product. If there is no glucose, they have to go with the choice of lactose. When lactose metabolism is needed, this lacopyran will be switched on. If there is no need of lactose metabolism, this lacopyran will become switched off. So this is known as lacopyran concept. By the next video, we'll learn about the lacopyran concept in detail.